In this video, we are going to see what's there in my makeup pouch. On a daily basis, I don't wear too much makeup. I, of course, do a little bit of makeup, like a little bit of concealing under my eyes, because I do have a little bit of darkness under my eyes, and I do have some pimple dark spots under my chin and some acne spots. So I do some spot concealing and I apply some powder, and then I throw some kajal and other things and a little bit of lipstick on. So this is what I do on a daily basis, but I don't go for any kind of heavy foundations or any kind of contouring, blush, highlighting and all those things. When it comes to videos, I do apply a lot of makeup, and of course we are shooting in HD cameras and we have to do a little bit of heavier makeup so as to look nice, so that you guys can watch us in a pleasant way. In this video, I'm gonna show you what I carry in a makeup pouch, where I, if in case I go for a party or in case I go for any kind of special occasions, what I do carry in my makeup pouch and what are the most essential things which I use on that time. So let's see what is there in it. So the first product which is there in my makeup bag is Hourglass Whale Primer. This is a beautiful primer which gives you a flawless skin, and I have a travel size which is a quite smaller one because I just love this to be there in my makeup bag on a daily basis, so I keep the smaller travel size in my makeup bag. First product is a primer, and the next one is a SPF. I use 50 plus SPF for this Indian climatic conditions, so I use Shiseido 50 plus SPF. And the next thing is I slap some moisturizer. The moisturizer which I really like is Clinique's Turnaround Overnight Moisturizer. I do use it because this is a nice heavy moisturizer. So of course it doesn't leave your skin heavy, it is very light, but it keeps your skin really nice and hydrated and gives you a nice supple feeling. So I apply this moisturizer. Then I go for a foundation. If it is going to be a very light, easy day, I love this foundation. This is my newfound luxury love. This is YSL's Cushion Foundation. This is called as Fusion Ink Cushion Foundation. So that's a beautiful foundation. Just looks like another skin on you. It doesn't give you any kind of cakey feeling or anything like that you have applied any foundation on. So it's an absolutely beautiful foundation. So this is my newfound love. And apart from that, if in case I want to go for a little bit more coverage, then I go for this foundation. Of course, you all know this is the Vanish Foundation Stick by Hourglass. So I open this and show you. So this is how it is, and it's a beautiful stick, and you all know that this is again another skin-like foundation which doesn't give you any cakey feeling. It just looks like your second skin. So I love this foundation. So I use this foundation stick if in case I want to have a little bit more coverage. So this is a must in my makeup bag. And the concealer which I'm loving these days is the Norse concealer. This concealer is called as Spot Matte Complete Concealer, and this is again a very good concealer. It's again very light and it really covers the purpleness under the eye and any kind of spot concealing also. This is a wonderful concealer. I do love MAC Studio Fix concealer, but now I'm taking a break from MAC concealer and I'm using this NARS more and loving it more. And the next product is, which is a standard staple always in my makeup bag, is this powder. This is MAC Studio Fix Fix in NC40, which is my color, and I think literally for last 10 years or something like that, I have used many of these MAC Studio Fix powders. Like, I run out of this very frequently as I use it on a daily basis. The next product which I love the most is the Bombs Bahama Mama contouring thing. This is a beautiful contour because this is a cool toned bronzer, so it gives you a nice shadow effect. It doesn't give you a muddy feel or any kind of oranginess in your contouring, so this gives a nice shadow. So I love this color. This is more suitable for all kind of Indian skin tones, definitely not too dark, but for any medium tones it's more suitable. And the next product is a blush. This is from Guerlain. And the color which I use the most is a rose. This color is called as rose, which is a natural blush. I love this color on a daily basis. This is more a nice blush to wear it on a daily basis, which doesn't show up much color on your skin. It just gives you a natural flush look and doesn't look dirty on your skin or too much on your skin. Okay, next thing is a North Radiant Creamy Concealer, and this is to brighten under the eyes. Of course, I do have a little bit of dark circles, so I use this concealer to brighten up my under eyes. And the next product is a lip pencil. This is a standard pencil which I use it on a daily basis. The color is a blaze. This is a very normal color, so it just goes well with a lot of sticks. I do change the lip colors very frequently, and currently I'm using this color. This color is from Yves Saint Laurent's matte lipstick. Color is 11. It's a nice pinky nude color which just gives a very natural lip. Lipstick I'm using these days, falling in love with this lipstick. This is Tom Ford's lipstick, and the color is called Twist of Fate. So this is again a beautiful color which is very natural, which just goes well with this lip color nicely. So this is the newfound love in terms of lipstick. I do change my lip colors daily based on the attire and based on the color of my clothing. I do change it, but these are more regular colors. And of course, I always love this product. Again, this is my favorite. I'm using this for ages, and not this one, the very same one. I often run out of this one. This is a lip volumizer from Estee Lauder. Leaves your lips really plumpy and nice and keeps away from any dry lips. And the next product is mascara. This is again from Guerlain, a regular mascara, but I love this one. Other one is kohl pencil. This is a waterline pencil. I cannot leave the house without a kohl pencil, and this one is 24/7 waterline pencil. The color is Legend by Urban Decay. And the next one is a eyeliner. So you can see how fine the tip of this eyeliner is, and it has a very fine tip. This is called a Tattoo Liner by Kat Von D. So I do line my eyes using this Kat Von D liner. Of course, I do use a beauty blender. Of course, this is a white beauty blender. You can see the color. And that's a tiny beauty blender which I use it for my under eye settings. And of course, a very important product I missed, which is this Dior, which is this Dior highlighter. It's, of course, everyone knows this, this one. How popular is this one? This is Dior Nude Air Luminizer in number one. So this is again a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful highlighter. Must have for anyone. So, and the next thing are my dirty brushes. So these are the regular brushes I do carry on a daily basis, apart from the beauty blender. So one brush for blush. This is an angled brush, so that it just make the blush sit nicely on the cheeks. And the other one is a contouring brush. You can see the shape of this brush is like 109 from MAC. So I like this 109 for contouring. It's just more like that. I wanted to try this brand, Ebelin. So, and the next one is a Morphe brush. I use this for highlighter. And this one again from Ebelin. It's a German brand, and this is again for concealing. So these are the brushes I use on a daily basis, and the beauty blenders and products. This is what is there in my makeup pouch on a daily basis. So this is my makeup pouch. This is not any big brand or anything like that. It's from H&M. Oh, I have one more thing in this one. This is the sharpener. Again, the sharpener is from Bobbi Brown. Of course, for the pencils, either for the eye pencil or for the lip pencil, I do always carry a sharpener, so that like it's always having a sharp. So these are the things that goes into my makeup bag. And this bag is from H&M, some random bags, because this gets dirty very often, so I keep changing my makeup pouch, so I don't go for any big bags as far as the. There you go. That's my makeup pouch. I hope you girls really like this video and also the things which I showed in my makeup pouch. And if in case you have any doubts on the makeup, you can ask me. You can leave comments below, and of course we welcome your comments. And if you really like this video, don't forget to hit on the like button and also subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit on the bell button near the subscribe so as to get the notifications of the videos immediately once they are posted on the channel. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay beautiful. Bye-bye.